Michele Carnley, and this is a UZ special report. I am with Wesley Odom, and he is the president of the Friends of the Saenger Theater. How are you doing today?
I'm doing real well. It's a pleasure to be here, Michele.
Well, thank you. So tell me, we've got a big event coming up in Pensacola. Tell me a little bit about what that's all about.
Well, it's called the Pensacola In Film and Music Gala, and it is going to be a first-class event down at the Saenger Theater on April the 24th this year from 7:30 to around 9:30. And basically, it's a special feature where we've invited some artists who've sung about Pensacola, and they're going to perform in front of us all. And also, we're going to see the premiere showing of Pensacola In Film and Music, which is a story about how Pensacola has been depicted in film over the last 90 years.
You know what happened to the Pensacola? The Los Angeles will probably experience weather conditions far worse than the Pensacola's ever seen.
The Hellcats?
Yes, but don't let that throw you. Remember, you're representing Pensacola.
We started in 2005 collecting the data. It was Ken Manning, who's an artist here locally, and I worked on the project, and then we got together with our favorite, Bill Thomas Katt, to put it together. And together we put this thing, finished it in 2009, and now it's going to be showcased.
So tell me, why is this event important to the Pensacola community?
Well, it's important because a lot of people don't realize how interesting a musical past Pensacola has, and also the fact that Pensacola shows up in a lot of movies and a lot of TV shows that you wouldn't think about. And it's interesting, and if we don't document this type of information, people will forget those songs of Pensacola, and people will forget about the mentions and the movies and whatnot.
Is this about that pool guy?
We found your hair on the towel bar that killed him.
He was so gorgeous. Showing up at my door. Things like that don't happen to me back in Pensacola.
Well, I thought all the diamonds were under your supervision.
These aren't from our lab. The manufacturing facility in Pensacola puts a code on every diamond they make. The inventory is continually checked.
Yes, we do have a CD that's going to be sold. It's sold by Friends of the Saenger there at the event. There's about 16 songs, I believe, on the CD, and we're going to have six of the artists play for the show. They're coming up from as far away as Nashville and Baltimore.
So if you're walking out on the beach on a starlit night, and you're looking out over Gulf Breeze, and you see a strange sight, yes, it might be an airplane or a tower light, but if you remember my story, you just might be surprised. It might be a Gulf Breeze UFO. I thought they were only science fiction. What did I know?
UFO.
Yes, it might be a Gulf Breeze UFO. I didn't know where it came from then, or where it was gonna go.
But we're really excited about this particular project because it is very, very unique to Pensacola. If you've lived here for any amount of time, you know how special a place it is. And if you listen to any of the great music that's around, you'll recognize some very familiar names out and about in this production. So come on down and enjoy it.
Take me down to Perdido Beach. That's the place where I can reach my full potential. Check out my differential.
Hopefully people can get their favorite artists to sign these programs. Even Phil Thomas Katt did a song about Pensacola. I don't know if you realize that out there, but he did. And he's going to be one of our artists who's going to be in the CD.
Take me back to the vagabond. Now he's dreaming about the legend, but it seems so real. The hippies driving.
Got a lot of good people out there who are going to be surprised about who they see on this thing. The tickets are $10, and they're going to be on sale at the Saenger Theater, so you can go on, call the Saenger. They're $10 each, and they get you into the whole production. And all the proceeds, I should say, go to the benefit of the Saenger Theater.
Okay. Now, we know that the main gala event is April the 24th. Will you have a rerun, so to speak, of it? And in case tickets sell out and people miss it, are you going to have that where people can actually come back and see it again?
You know, that's a great question, Michelle. And I think that there might be a demand for that, perhaps. We've been receiving a lot of good comments about this whole thing. And there's a real possibility that we might decide to do a matinee show that before then. For people who are members of Friends of the Saenger and people who are guest sponsors, there's a special VIP party ahead of time inside the Saenger Theater just before the show gets open for the general admission. But there is a possibility that if we do sell out, we will open up a matinee, and we've got to negotiate with some people to sing another song, I guess. So we're going to sell the CDs and also the DVDs of the production. So the DVD of the production will be the film itself, Pensacola In Film and Music, and then the CDs will have all the 16 songs that have been highlighted. And what we did is we took the best of the best of the songs that have been produced about Pensacola. And there's more out there. I was talking to another artist the other day, and they had written two additional songs about Pensacola. I was talking to Ricky Whitley the other day, and he said, he wrote a song called Lillian Highway Blues, and he said, you know, now I need to be focused on more Pensacola songs if you're interested.
Walking down at Lillian Highway, you and I ain't got nothing to lose. I'm walking down at Lillian Highway, you know what, I ain't got nothing to lose. My baby left me down in Pensacola, well, I got them Lillian Highway Blues. I'm walking down that Lillian Highway, might stop off by Myrtle Grove. I'm walking down that Lillian Highway, might stop off by Myrtle Grove. And when I get my business done there, I think I might just head on down to Mobile, that's what I know.
So I think it's great that people and artists are interested in the area, that they're singing about the area, because we do have some unique aspects about Pensacola that only we know about. So anyway, I would encourage you guys to come on down and enjoy that, because it's going to be a fun time, and hopefully it's oversubscribed and we have to rent another night for the Saenger. We'll do that if necessary. We'll do it.
Now, the CD and the gala itself and the DVD sales, that's basically going to help pay for the reconstruction of the Saenger Theater. Is that correct?
Well, yes. We've done a lot. There was a multi-million-dollar reconstruction of the Saenger Theater, and the Friends of the Saenger still owes a pledge on some of that money. We're also hoping to use proceeds of these profits of these to fund the organ. There's an organ there that was original to the Saenger, not 1926, and it's in pretty bad shape. So we want to probably set aside some money for that. And also, any time that a CD is sold, we're gonna also pay those artists. They get some of the proceeds. It's not like these artists just gave us the songs. We said, no, we want to pay royalties for these local artists, because we really want to promote local created music.
Well, again, give me the, of course, we all know it's at the Saenger Theater, but give me the day and the time.
April the 24th. It starts at 7:30 and ends at 9:30 that night. It'll be a great event. If you're into local stuff, you're into local music, if you're into local films or even national films that mention Pensacola, I think you'll be playing Trivial Pursuit with yourself that night when you say, oh, I remember that film, or oh, I didn't know that was on TV, I didn't know Pensacola was set in that film, or whatever. I think you'll be surprised. It's a very pride-inspiring event, and something I hope that a lot of Pensacolians will be able to come out for.
Well, Wesley, I certainly appreciate you joining me today, and for all the insightful information that you've given us, and hopefully you'll have a great turnout for this event.
We thank you very much. Thank you for being on UZTV.